Welcome to Unfold Data Science, friends. This is Aman here and I am a data scientist. In this video, I'll explain you the concept of stochastic gradient descent with an example. So this is basically a optimizer in deep neural network we use generally. So what is an optimizer? A way to optimize your weight. Okay. So how the weights are optimized in typical gradient descent is like this. So this is how the gradient descent optimizes the weight in a deep neural network. If you see, so I had created a detailed video on how this works. The link you can see right here. Just a refresher. What it does is it will just see the loss function, take the derivative of the loss function with respect to the weight it has to optimize, and then create the new weight. So new weight is nothing but old weight adjusted against that gradient and the training learning rate. Okay. So this is how the weight gets adjusted. Now the loss function is important here. To make it simple, I am taking the example of a linear regression. So this is how the loss function for linear regression looks like, right? So actual minus predicted whole square, or predicted minus actual whole square, okay? Now imagine if we have two data points in the training, right? Just two data points in the training. Then this term expands to y1 minus y hat 1 whole square, y hat 2 minus y2 whole square, right? This is term 1 and this is term 2. This becomes the loss function for a linear regression. Now this needs to be optimized for what? When I say optimized, minimized for what? For this m and this c, right? So m and c are the parameters of linear regression. How do you do that? You take the derivative of this with respect to m and then try to find out the best m for this. You take the derivative of this with respect to c and try to find out the updated c with respect to this loss function. Now here we are talking about two points in our training data and two parameters to optimize, correct? Two points in the training data, two parameters to optimize. So how many times we need to take the derivative? Take the derivative of this term with respect to m, take the derivative of this term with respect to c, and same way for this term as well. So 2 cross 2. So four derivatives we need to take. Now imagine a situation where your data set has, let us say, 10,000 rows and 15 features to be optimized. So what I'm saying here is there are 15 columns in your data, 1 to 15, okay? And number of rows are like 10,000. So how many terms will come in that linear regression equation, loss function? 10,000 terms, right? And all these 10,000 terms need to be optimized for these 15 parameters. So computationally, it becomes very expensive. And that is the downside of typical gradient descent. And that is where stochastic gradient descent helps us. So in this case, we are talking about term 1 plus term 2 plus term 3 plus up to term 10,000, right? This loss function needs to be optimized 15 individual variables or columns. So what stochastic gradient does is, it does not take all these 10,000 rows into consideration. Rather, it takes one random row out from this, okay? So when it takes one random row out from this, then this term does not have 10,000, you know, observations. This will have just one term, T1. This one term needs to be optimized for these 15 features. And that is where the optimization becomes simpler than, computation wise, it becomes simpler than the previous method that we used. That is normal gradient descent. Okay. This is the difference between gradient descent and stochastic gradient descent. Gradient descent takes the whole data. Stochastic gradient descent takes, let us say in its basic form, one record at a random. But there are downsides of that. What is the downside? The downside is, when you take one record out from an observation of 10,000, then your results might be biased, okay? It is quite possible that this one record is not in sync with all other records. There might be outliers here, there might be some other things. Due to that, this weight that we got for, let us say, variable 1 or weight 1, that might be biased, okay? That is the problem with taking one record out. So there is a way out. We cannot take one record, we cannot take 10,000 record, and this is computationally expensive. So there is something called mini batch gradient descent or stochastic gradient descent. What it does, it will just take a batch of records from this 10,000 record. Let us say 100 records. If you set the batch size as 100, then in this 10,000 terms, you will just see 100 terms, okay? T1 to T100. So we have reduced our computation from 10,000 to 100, and at the same time, we are, you know, suppressing the effect of this bias term here. It should not be biased, right? So when 100 records are selected at random, less possibility of it being biased. This is about mini batch gradient descent. Now, just to give you an intuition how this works is, if you take an example of a simple gradient descent, I'm sure you remember this curve here. This is a parabola that needs to be optimized, for example. So let us say your weight starts from here, W old, right? W old is here. So this is your loss function, and this is where is the minimum of that loss function. Now, when W old is here and you apply a gradient descent, what happens is all your records are there in that loss function, and hence the optimization of this weight will be faster. Try to understand, guys. You started with 10,000 records. I'm talking about normal gradient descent. When you apply a loss function on all these 10,000 records, then your weight optimization will be faster. Computation will be expensive, but weight optimization will happen faster. So what will happen? It will start going like this, from here to here, here to here, here to here, and it will reach here probably, okay? But when you take a stochastic gradient descent, what happens is, out of these 10k records, you are just taking, let's say in mini batch also, 100 records. It is quite possible that your weight might not optimize very sharply like this. So when you take a next subset of 100, your weight might go here and there. Eventually it will come here, but to come here, it might go maybe little bit this side, little bit this side, little bit here, little bit here. Okay, this is a time consuming process for weight optimization. So when we reduce the computational power, computational, you know, work, then our weights might take a zigzag path, not a straight path, right? So this process is called, you know, more time will take for your weight to optimize in a mini batch gradient descent. In a normal gradient descent, it might come very sharply. There is a solution for this as well. So if you have heard of something called momentum in SGD, right? Momentum in SGD. So when you use stochastic gradient descent as your optimizer in a neural network, and when you use momentum, then this problem is taken care by a bigger margin, okay? But to explain momentum, I need to explain you few mathematical concepts behind it, okay? If you want me to explain momentum, write me in comment, I want to understand momentum. If I get like 15-20 comments, I'll definitely create a separate video on SGD with momentum, SGD plus momentum, okay? So this is how we use stochastic gradient descent with momentum in as an optimizer in my deep neural network. So I'm sure you would have understood how gradient descent works. If you have any doubt, I strongly recommend you watch my last video on gradient descent. Understand gradient descent, stochastic gradient descent, mini batch gradient descent, and gradient descent momentum. These are important, and then we will go to Adam and other optimizers. So these are other optimizers in neural networks. So all the optimizers we'll cover one by one. So if you have any doubts, write me in comment. I'll see you all in the next video. Till then, stay safe and take care.